I'm Austin Prock. Welcome to John Force Racing. Let's go check it out. We're at the far end of John Force Racing, and we're going to start with our paint and graphics department. Each one of our race cars either gets painted or wrapped down here. We do everything in-house. This is one of Robert Height's cars down here for repairs. It's got the, looks like the AAA logos burnt off the side of it, so gonna get that tuned up and it'll be ready for Houston. This is the graphics department for John Force Racing. Everything from the trailers to race cars gets wrapped or painted in-house, so all that magic happens down here. Right now, Andrew, he's our graphics designer and painter. He's prepping some stuff to go repair Robert Height's car. I spent a lot of time in here as a kid bugging Andrew and one of the old painters to come down here and paint my helmets, and you know, had a lot of fun growing up down here. This is our anodizing room. A lot of the parts that we make in-house are made out of aluminum, which is acceptable to be anodized. The only color we run in here is black. Keeps our race cars looking clean and nice, and Duke, he gets all the anodizing done for us. We made it into John Force Racing's fab shop. I'm gonna give you guys a close-up look at what we build in here and some of the fixtures that we use. So right here we have a Chevrolet Camaro. All of our bodies get the tin work, the titanium tree assembly, all of that installed here and hung on the chassis. We also build our top fuel dragsters and funny cars in-house. This is the top fuel dragster jig. My brother Thomas actually designed this fixture and it builds an extremely nice race car. Over here we have the funny car jig. They're constantly building front halves and things like that to keep stocked up in case, you know, anything goes wrong throughout the middle of the season. We got some headers being made right now. You know, just trying to get stocked up for this season. And this is the fixture. There's a lot of performance in the headers nowadays with laying them back, so they take their time and make sure they're built absolutely correct. Over here we've got a booth to do carbon fiber work in. A lot of the funny car bodies, they'll you know, get a crack or something and need repaired, so they'll do that right in-house down here. We've made it to John Force Racing's machine shop now. We've got our Herco machines running 24/7, it seems like. We build a lot of parts in-house. I think over 100 parts and pieces, all the way from the short blocks, cylinder heads, superchargers, manifolds, and you know, other knickknacks. So this is a view of some of the things we make here in-house. What's up, Sam? Look, we even got crew chiefs running the machines. This is Chris Cunningham, crew chief on Robert Height's car. What are you building today, Chris? Okay. How's it going? Yeah. This machine here, it repairs some of our short blocks. This is Jacob in here. He's got one up in the machine and making sure it's perfectly zeroed in there to make a tight tolerance. This is kind of the brains of the machine shop in here. This is where the engineers hang out. We've got our lead engineer, Tom Warga, hard at it. You don't see him away from his desk very often, so always busy improving our parts and pieces to you know, go out and win races. We've got a few manual machines here. I spend a lot of time on this lathe here, you know, whittling out, you know, special projects for my race car, or whether it's that or building superchargers. So I'll cut all my blower rotors down on that lathe and make sure all the tolerances are perfect to make the perfect amount of boost for these things. We've made it to the parts department for John Force Racing. Everything that we need to stock up these trailers we have right here in-house. Each team's got a little sheet to sign things out, and just grab what you can get and roll. This is my brother Sam. He manages the parts department and is a general manager of John Force Racing. We always give him a hard time, but he's a good dude. Look, short blocks just laying on the floor ready for picking. some blower parts for building superchargers. I raid this area quite often. Love building superchargers and got everything I need in here. Got CP pistons for days. We'll order in huge bulk, you know, because we have four teams, and that way, you know, we never get in a predicament where we're running out of something. Got crankshafts, darting sleeves, ignition things over here. This hallway holds a lot of our dynos. We have clutch dynos, supercharger dynos, flow benches, ignition dynos, all kinds of things like that. This is the blower dyno. Check out what Mark's got going on in here. Mark, you getting her ironed out? This is my ride here at John Force Racing. This facility is huge, and when you're working down in the fab shop and you need to come grab something out of the trailer for a measurement or anything like that, it's way quicker to ride this bad boy than walk. We've made it to the coolest part of John Force Racing, where all the race cars hang out. Each trailer's parked in here just like we do at the racetrack. The pits are set up the same as at the racetrack as well, so the crew guys have some familiarity with, you know, just getting in the groove of things. And check out what we got going in Robert Heights pit over here. They've been hard at it. They got some fresh pipe after Vegas and getting it all ready to go for Houston. Get a close-up look at 13,000 horsepower. Nate, you're in the way. One of our beautiful Chevy Camaros. Got Brittany Force's team hard at it over here. Look, there's even David Grubnick in the house. And finally, we've made it to the greatest pit of all, mine, Montana brand, Rocky Mountain Twist. Mikey, what do we got going on down here?
Oh, fiving up a holder for a front tire to go in the back of Suburban.
Come on. Yeah, I was working on this earlier before these guys showed up. I was a little late. This is my top fuel dragster. You guys can get a close-up look at what my office looks like. We spent a lot of time over the off-season making this thing as nice as it possibly could be, and she came out like jewelry, so definitely proud of this thing. This is one of our two haulers. Got a few of my guys down here working on the clutch assembly. My brother Thomas, he builds a clutch on this car, and he's also an engineer for us, so great guy to have in our corner. Got Don Lynch building some cylinder heads. Got some freshies to go to Houston, and we're gonna come out gun swinging. I'll give you guys a little look at my office on the road and here. It's a little messy, but got a practice tree in here, so I pretty much live on this thing. Whether I'm at the racetrack or in the shop, I try and hit it every day. It's like racing John Force, he was hanging me out there. Top secret down there. Give her one more go. I'm a little lazy this morning. Yeah, that was good. 95 on this thing's like a 30. Up next, we have a tribute room to Eric Medlin. He was a one of our John Force Racing teammates that we lost in 2007 due to an accident in one of these funny cars. But there's a lot of cool memories and pictures in here of Eric. Eric was a hero of mine. We were great friends, and he took me under my wing, or he took me under his wing when I was getting started racing. Actually got me my first sponsorship and hooked me up with all my racing gear to get my career started. So a lot of cool things in here. There's a few of Eric's helmets in here. Eric actually got me into painting helmets, and that's one of the reasons I still do today. my Rookie of the Year helmet in 2019, I actually had a whole bunch of old metal flake that was Eric's prior to his accident, and I saved it aside to paint, you know, one of my first helmets with it. So that helmet's got a lot of meaning to me. I can remember a lot of these things as a kid, you know, looking up to Eric. This was always one of my favorite helmets of his. He was a very talented painter and one heck of a guy. Down here is some of Eric's fire safety equipment from one of his fires, his most known fires probably. I actually have the other boot of that down there, and it looks about the same. It's kind of crazy what the fire does to our safety gear. This is one of his go-karts that he had. I can remember the first time I ever went and watched him. I don't know if he was trying to show off, but it was the first corner. He ended up in the hay bales and got knocked out of the race, but I can always remember that story and get a good laugh out of it. It's one of Eric's fire suits. Him and his mom up there, Mimi. Over here is, this is actually a picture of me back in 2007 after Eric's accident. But kind of cool seeing stuff like this up there. This wall always cracks me up looking at how young everybody was. And this is kind of Eric's office, some of the things that were in his office, you know, they put up here. And this is always nice to look at. No one can ever be sad eating ice cream. That was always Eric's slogan. And we still eat ice cream in Sonoma every year for him. We're up above the race shop here at John Force Racing, and I'm gonna give you a quick tour of some of the cool things we have in here. We got a museum full of old memorabilia and a lot of winning race cars. There's, it's not quite like the John Force Racing in Yorba Linda, that's quite the museum, but we got some of the overflow in here. A couple of my old Montana brand canopies. Got Brittany Force's Top Fuel Dragster and her Super Comp car, or actually that's Courtney's, and one of Courtney's old bodies. This is one of my favorites back here, is the tribute to Jeff Gordon. I thought that was really cool when Force landed the Chevrolet deal and pay a great tribute to one of the greatest racers of all. This is one of the coolest things up here, the old two-hole injector. This thing was designed by John Medlin and the other part of the brain trust at John Force Racing. It was a really cool idea and made a ton of horsepower, but with the two big blades so far back in the injector, it was hard to cut a good reaction time with. The thing was real lazy on the starting line, so we ended up having to get away from it, but definitely one of the cool products that we produced here. The old American flag peak funny car. I actually got to drive this car in Norwalk at the Night Under Fire race, and that was one of the coolest moments of my life, being able to drive this iconic John Force car. That was a behind the scenes look at John Force Racing. I hope you guys enjoyed. Now get out of here, I got work to do.